You're watching Daytime Tea Times with Candice. It's time to pour this tea, stir this tea, and sip this tea. Let's get right into it. All right, everybody, welcome to Daytime Tea Time. If you're new to my channel, my name is Candice. If you haven't already, please make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you will always know when I upload. All right, let's get into the tea. Okay, you guys, so actress and comedian Loni Love, who is known for being one of the co-hosts from the multi-Emmy award-winning daytime TV show, The Real, she's getting some backlash on social media for a tweet that she put out today. She was trying to tell a joke, but a lot of people felt like it was a little bit insensitive. Now, y'all know I always tell y'all what I personally think, but I'm gonna tell you guys what had happened first. Okay, so this is what Loni Love tweeted. So OJ is on Twitter. He decided to take a stab at it. ... Don't at me. Okay, so for those of you who do not know, who are probably a little too young, you may not know that OJ Simpson is an ex-football player who was accused of murdering his wife and the mother of his children, Nicole Brown Simpson, as well as a man by the name of Ron Goldman. So when Loni Love says that OJ Simpson is taking a stab at joining Twitter, people feel like that's very insensitive to the woman and men who died and their families who continue to grieve over their deaths, and the fact that the man who allegedly did it is still walking free and joining Twitter. So people feel like Loni Love was a little insensitive, and they did not hesitate to let Loni Love know how they feel. Some people did laugh and say that her joke was funny, but there were far more people saying that she was corny, not funny, very insensitive to the family and the people who died, comments like that. So this topic obviously made its way to the blog. The Shade Room posted it, and a lot of people were getting at Loni in the comment section. This person said, "Why do people make jokes like this, like two innocent people didn't lose their lives that night? This actually wasn't funny at all. Why make a joke about a sensitive situation where people were killed?" Then this person made fun of Loni's weight. "Sis barking up the wrong tree. I hate when people make senseless jokes about incidents where someone lost a child, mother, or sister. So ignorant, and it wasn't funny. That's not funny. She canceled. That's not funny at all, and it shows the lack of comics abilities when they have to resort to such tasteless jokes." And the comments went on and on about how insensitive Loni Love was for making a joke about people who died. Okay, now it's time for my opinion. It may be an unpopular opinion. Y'all might not like me after this, but listen, I'm about to say what I say. Yes, absolutely, the joke was insensitive. Do I think it was funny? No, not at all. But the thing is, in my personal opinion, when it comes to a comedian, I remember a time when there was nothing that was off limits. I remember a time when a comedian can make a joke, and even if it's the meanest thing in the world, people were still laughing. And I'm talking about jokes about people with disabilities, mental illness.
My name, look down. My name, look down. Leave me alone. My name, look down.
People's weight, being fat, being too short, being too skinny, being too tall, being gay. But now if we laugh about those things, the LGBTQ+ gonna get us, the disability group's gonna get us. Any group that stands up for the people we laughing at, they gonna get us because we're making a joke about them. And I'm just saying, I'm waiting for the moment where comedians can make a joke and you just laugh or you don't laugh. And I stress, I personally don't think the joke was funny that Loni made. I wouldn't make the joke, but I'm just saying, let a comedian tell their joke without them having to be canceled or people don't want to watch their TV show no more. Like, people were really saying that Loni's gonna lose her job over this. I don't think so. I hope not, at least. I'm just saying, a comedian should be able to make a joke. Let me just remind you guys how one of our favorite comedians made a joke. It was a little insensitive, but y'all know y'all was all in the theater laughing at it. Check this out, and then I'm coming back with some more.
Now, I probably wouldn't say this in front of white folk, but in front of y'all, I'm gonna speak my mind. Rosa Parks ain't do nothing but sit her black ass down. No, hold on now, Seinfeld. You might learn something right now. I'm gonna give her a just due. I'm gonna give her a just due for what she did, her act led to the movement and everything. But she damn sure ain't special. No, it was a whole lot of black folk sat down on bus and they got thrown in jail, and they did it way for Rosalie. Only difference between them and her is that she's secretary at the NAACP and she know Martin Luther King, and they got a lot of publicity.
That's all I have to say. What? To me, it sounds like you got a little haterism in your game.
Well, Kevin, God, no, this ain't no hateration or no holleration in this dancery, okay? What I'm saying is that black people need to stop lying.
Say something.
There's three things that black people need to tell the truth about.
What?
One, Rodney King should have got an ass beat for driving drunk and being grown in a Hyundai. Two, OJ did it.
OJ did it.
And three, Rosa Parks ain't do nothing but sit her black ass down.
That's
right. I said it.
Okay, so you guys see that. Now, if you're old enough, you know that that movie is called The Barbershop. If you never seen it, you too young. Go Google it. But anyway, Cedric the Entertainer made fun of Rosa Parks, Rodney King, and OJ Simpson in the movie. And y'all know y'all was sitting there laughing. But fast forward to 2019, Loni Love makes a joke about OJ Simpson, and now everybody's saying she canceled. Y'all better go on somewhere with that. I'm just saying. But anyway, speaking of OJ Simpson, if you missed it, yes, he has a Twitter account. Yes, he's a clout chaser, okay? He wants attention. I don't know how he getting his money these days, but clearly somebody told him to get back on Twitter, maybe get you an Instagram account. People gonna pay you to post stuff and you can make some money. Cause he definitely trying to get attention. He wanted to publicly deny the rumor that he is in fact the father of Kris Jenner's daughter, Khloé. He says he is not the baby daddy and he says he was not ever sexually involved with Kris Jenner. Check this out and then I'm coming back with some more.
Hey Twitter world, this is yours truly. Now coming soon to Twitter, you'll get to read all my thoughts and opinions on just about everything. Now there's a lot of fake OJ accounts out there. So this one, @TheRealOJ32 is the only official one. So this should be a lot of fun. I got a little getting even to do. So God bless, take care. Hello Twitter world, this is yours truly. You know, this is my first venture into the social media world and it's amazing. You know, especially how quickly they can put up counterfeit sites. Anyway, we'll deal with that. My life has always been involved in the sports world, and I suspect as the weeks goes on, that's pretty much what we'll be talking about. But once in a while, I'm going to go off topic and talk about something else. And this is one of those times. You know, Bob Kardashian, he's like a brother to me. He's a great guy. He met and married Chris, and they really had a terrific time together when they were together. Unfortunately, that ended. But never, and I want to stress, never in any way, shape, or form had I ever had any interest in Chris romantically, sexually, and I never got any indication that she had any interest in me. So all of these stories are just bogus, bad, you know, tasteless. Khloé, like all the girls, I'm very proud of, just like I know Bob would be if he was here. But the simple facts of the matter is she's not mine. Now, one of the people who's spreading this rumor is a guy that the media loves to say is my manager. I had one manager in my whole life, Chuck Barnes, when I came out of USC for 3 years. Unfortunately, he died about 45 years ago. But even before he died, I opened my own office with the help of Skip Taft, my lawyer, my two assistants, Marilyn O'Brien, the late Marilyn O'Brien, and Kathy Randa. And I've always managed my own affairs, and I like to think very successfully. So when you see these guys like Norm and these guys claim that they're my manager, it's just not true. I may have done a deal here or there with them, but none of these guys have ever was anything remotely like a manager for me. In any event, that's it for today. Happy Father's Day. Take care.
You guys see that? That was some of OJ Simpson's first few posts on Twitter after he came back, trying to clout chase and get some attention. Now there was another OJ Simpson page, like a fake page, making jokes. OJ Simpson did not like it, and he actually DM'd the person. And that person put OJ Simpson on blast, okay? OJ actually had the nerve to threaten this person with knife emojis and kinda insinuated that he actually did kill his ex-wife. Which isn't really a surprise, considering he did a whole book and interview talking in detail about if he did it, this how I would've did it. Okay, so the fake account says, "You gonna cut me? Awesome. Is that what you said to Nicole?" And then OJ Simpson put a whole bunch of knife emojis talking about you're next. All right, OJ, you have our attention. Now go ahead and make your money on Twitter and Instagram, because I'm sure he gonna make an Instagram coming up soon. I'm telling y'all, OJ Simpson is a clout chaser, okay? Bye, OJ, bye, bye, bye. I'm hoping we're done talking about OJ Simpson. But all right, y'all, I'm done with this. I wanna know what y'all think. What do you guys think about Loni Love getting dragged in the comment section for the joke that she made? Do you think it was insensitive? Or do you think it was just a joke? And what do you think about OJ Simpson being back on Twitter? Let me know what you think. If you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that like button, and I'm gonna catch you in the next one, all right?
Bye.